In this video, I share my braised short rib recipe that is prepared in an electric pressure cooker XL. I highly recommend the Power Pressure Cooker XL 6-quart featured in this recipe. I've been creating recipes in this electric appliance since late 2016. It is by far one of my favorite kitchen tools because it locks in flavor of each meal and it is super easy to clean. This recipe calls for a Cabernet Sauvignon semi-dry red wine. I picked up a new item at Aldi. The wine is called the 30 Mile Napa California, which is a Cabernet Sauvignon. The wine costs a little more than I normally spend for a weekday meal, but I figured I'd give it a try. The cost was $17.99. The flavor was nice and dry. To be honest with you, it didn't taste much different from my $3.99 bottle of Winking Owl that I also purchased at Aldi. So I went ahead and used the Winking Owl in the short rib recipe featured today. I want to note that when cooking with wine, only use what you would drink. If you don't drink wine and only use it in cooking, well, good for you. You must enjoy how a good wine will add the most amazing flavor and tenderness to meat if cooked properly. Let's get on with the recipe because I could talk about fun wines that I recommend for a few more slides. Here we go. In this recipe, you will need 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 1 medium sweet onion, 2 cloves of garlic minced, 8 ounces of baby bell mushroom sliced, 2 pounds of beef short ribs. If you can get your butcher to cut it with the bone in, that's perfect. 1.5 cups of red wine, preferably Cabernet Sauvignon, 2 tablespoons of dry thyme, 1 teaspoon of dried rosemary, 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt to taste, and 8 small cut in half red potatoes. Start out by warming up the pressure cooker. On my XL, I use the meat or chicken setting. This warms up the pot perfectly to saute and brown meats. Each pressure cooker or Instant Pot is different, so be sure to read your manufacturer's suggestions. Warm up the olive oil to saute the sliced sweet onion and garlic. Once they're sautéed, move the sauté to the side of the pot and add as many of the short ribs you can fit. I had to do 2 patches with the pieces I had. If you are using short rib with bone, you are in luck. The bone will add amazing flavor to the dish as well. Brown all sides of the short ribs. This took me about 10 to 15 minutes. Once the meat is browned on all sides, you will now remove from the pressure cooker pot so you can evenly spread the onion saute mix on the bottom of the pot again. Be sure to not set the meat on the plate that had raw meat. Lay the brown short ribs on top of the onions. Layer in mushroom before pouring the red wine in the pot. Now lay the red potato sliced side down on top of the mushroom. On top of the potatoes, add the herbs you decided to use. I highly recommend using fresh herbs. Of course, I grow herbs year-round in my dome greenhouse, so I always have them on hand. Today I used a bonnie plant variety of German thyme and just a pinch of rosemary I've been growing for years. Now, be sure when you add fresh herbs, you're going to want to cut the amount in half because fresh herbs are much more potent and stronger in flavor, which is awesome. Now it's time to shut the lid and set the timer to meat setting. On my XL, I set it on the meat chicken setting for about 15 minutes. It takes time for the pot to pressurize, and of course, after the set time, I like to let the pressure release slowly on its own, which adds another 15 to 20 minutes to the process. I've provided more images, printable recipe card, and links to products I've mentioned today in this presentation. I'd appreciate if you use my affiliate links on my website. Find more creative living and growing ideas on my website at brenhaas.com. Connect with me on social media at brenhaas.